I got it in my head that I could build a robot. I woke up one morning and decided that I was gonna make Warbot Defect B542-9671.
Maybe I'll just call you Clank.
And I didn't want him to be a 3D print that just sits on my shelf. I wanted him to be alive. I wanted him to be an animatronic, and of course, I wanted him to be in backpack form so I can carry him around at conventions. I don't have experience in animatronics, but I did make some articulating wings a couple years ago with Geeks on Podcast, and I've animated LEDs with Arduino before, but that's pretty much the extent of my experience. So most of this was trial and error, but I think I ended up with a pretty cool little guy. So enough talking and
let's build this thing.
For quite a while, I've been subscribed to James Bruton's channel. This is a wealth of information regarding robotics, and in one of his videos, he built a three-axis robotic head. This was the basis of, say, the first 2 months of this build. These were the downloadable files. For his servo control, instead of using an Arduino, I chose the root of a Pololu Maestro, which comes with an easy-to-use programming software. I got the Mini Maestro 12 because I thought I wanted a lot more servos in him, but the cheaper 6-channel would have been perfect for this project. I also bought some cheap servos on Amazon. This was my first test of the 3-axis head, and it was not bad. I even was able to quickly put it into sequence, though it took some time to figure out how to slow it down and ease the motions into one another. For the actual Clank model, I thought I'd skip a few steps and use this Clank figure from cults.com. I was really hoping I could skip modeling his outsides completely, but that was wishful thinking. In reality, while this file was extremely helpful at first, I eventually had to model most of it myself. The file was too low poly and kept breaking when I modified him. You could see polygons acting weird and intercepting each other when I tried to hollow it. This caused a lot of problems. Despite these errors, I did manage to make this first PLA print. This first head and three-axis mechanism helped me problem solve issues like this, where the weight of the head would get the servos into a feedback loop and shake. This was caused by a rickety mechanism and two quick movements. I eventually replaced the mechanism and animated a smoother code. For his eyes, I knew I wanted monitors with an animated movie file. His eyes do a lot of emoting since he doesn't have eyebrows, and I knew I'd just be disappointed in mechanical eyelids. After much searching, I found a Raspberry Pi Snake Eyes Bonnet project on the Adafruit website. This kit comes with the bonnet itself and headers. This is a small TFT display, and it comes with two of them, and it also comes with a lot of cables. These displays were the largest small ones that I could find. It was either way too big or just big enough, so this isn't a perfect fit, but it's definitely close enough. This is rated as an intermediate project on the site and requires a lot of soldering. They have a pretty lengthy tutorial on how to do the basic setup to use their OpenGLI program. I already knew that I wanted to replace the OpenGLI program, their basic standard eyes, with my own animated eyes, but it's best to get it working, then change the code later.
This is what my eyes currently look like. Not what we want. Well, now I have two, at least. Why?
I need some help with my Adafruit Snake Eyes bonnet. I am only getting this. And it's been about 3 days of me trying. I thought it might have been a hardware issue, like a wiring issue. I desoldered, resoldered. I tried 3 different Pi 3s. I have everything wired up correctly, like nothing crosses. I installed all the software probably 3 or 4 times over just in case I messed anything up, and I'm still getting kind of this same image. So I'd really appreciate any help if you have any ideas. Thanks. After 3 days on forums and a lot of wrong advice, I finally got the right advice, and this is the moment when I booted it up for the first time.
You're working. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
They work. It's actually mirrored over here too. But I finally got them to work. I installed the wrong operating system. I had installed an older version of the operating system on the Raspberry Pi. And that was it. Oh my gosh.
The next thing I had to tackle was his eye animation. The looping animation for his eyes was the easiest thing for me to make. I'm an animator in my day job and I work in Adobe After Effects all day, every day. So I just had to make a design that replicated his green lenses with solid black shapes at the top and bottom for his eyelids. Then I really just had some fun creating different expressions and blinks for him. I rendered it out with the correct size and positioning as a 30-second MP4 loop. Now that I had my animated MP4, I had to replace the OpenGL Snake Eyes program with an auto-start loop program in Python, while leaving the code that sends the information to the displays. And I don't know Python, so...
ChatGPT to write my code for me. And it's gotten me almost all the way there. But my eyes are playing across one monitor instead of both of them. All right, I'm rebooting. Hopefully this little display will update on both displays across the whole thing. Let's see. Nope. Oh. Nope. Dang it. And I got my eyes playing full screen on my HDMI display, but they're not updating there. So I'm gonna reboot and see if they'll update. No! Why? Just ran this code here and it made it full screen on both eyes, but it won't play from reboot and startup. But it's looking pretty good. Yes! Oh my gosh. I did it!
You did it?
I did it!
For his body, I did a complete overhaul and reshape. I inserted his hands so he's in backpack form, and I hollowed him out as much as possible with a cutout for a computer fan, the front door cutout, the top wide open for all of his animatronics. I also made a hefty bolt on his back with enough space and strength to slide in a backpack mount, and on the inside, I included a little magnet flap with magnet mounts. This didn't quite work out, but I'll show you how I made it work later. I printed his body all in one go in my Sonic 8K resin printer, and this is what it looked like. I had a couple of failures, a little bit on the back, and definitely that magnet holder in the middle. Everything otherwise looked fine, so I decided to go with this print because it took a million hours to print and a lot of resin. I also printed his feet at this time. Side note, they don't make flexible plates for the Sonic Mega 8K, so I just have to chisel it off. The door itself has a tongue that fits into a groove on the body. I had to adjust the door shape to account for it rotating into place. This is clearly not fitted yet. I did fix it, and when I printed it, it still didn't fit, so a lot of sanding was my solution. Slides in and will snap into place like this. On the inside of the body, my magnet holder failed, so I just sanded it down as flat as I could, and I'm gonna make little magnet holders, like little boxes. I'm gonna glue them just like two teeth right there. There they are, all glued in, and the door will... Oh my god. I glued it in. Five. realized that I needed to find a more vertical setup for my servos that would fit inside Clank's body, I found a channel called Hendrix Workshop that focuses entirely on animatronics. And this video has a design that I felt would work much better for Clank. It's still a 3D axis neck with three servos, but it's in a much more compact configuration. His files are for full-size servos and a full-size head, so I had to downsize everything to start. When it's scaled down for my mini servos, you could see how much more compact of a design this is than my original. Instead of 3D printed arms to control his movement, I now have 2mm threaded rods with attachable ball joint end pieces that allow for much more fluid movement. These will attach to the servos like this. This is what's called a cardan joint. That's an omnidirectional universal joint. And I attach this to a 3mm threaded rod that supports his head and side-to-side movement. So I finally have Clank's eyes, my lenses, printed. I haven't put a high gloss on them yet. I'm hoping once I sand them down, get a high gloss on it, they will be nice and clear. The edges are chipped because I had one hell of a time getting it off of my print bed and I don't have a wham-bam plate and essentially had to hammer them off. Now that I have these, they will go in my little eye. This is just for my test, they'll pop in just like so, just like that. They fit nice and flat. This goes right over it, and then this goes in like that. And then his eye will be nice and magnified. So it looks like in my little test print, I might need to move it down just a little bit. You can see some yellow there from the bottom of the monitor and a little bit of white on the end there. Maybe I'll move the indents for the holder, just like over like 2mm down and then like 1mm to the outside. I sprayed some gloss lacquer on these and they look really good. They look like glass. They're also magnifying a decent amount. If you see my fingers. Okay, let's plug it in and then wait for it to boot up. Well, that's a problem. But it's just a connection problem. So let's do a little troubleshooting, make sure everything's plugged in. Right one's actually okay. Left one's a little too far over. You can see the white on the side here. I'm gonna cover them with black on all sides so you also won't see the light at the bottom there, the yellow light, or any of the white sides. I made a custom base for the Raspberry Pi / riser. So I modeled the inside where it's angled for this angled and the back is angled. And it does fit in there pretty well, but I need to find a way to anchor this without having it be completely permanent in case I need to take out that Raspberry Pi. What I'm gonna do, and I could have modeled this if I had planned it a little bit better, is drill a hole directly through the back of his little risers here into the back of them here. Okay, here we go. Bolt going all the way through, and it's just a little teeny tiny bolt in the back. I don't think that's going anywhere. This is my first test head. You can see I made holes for the arms, and the top of the animatronic pieces didn't fit, so I just drilled it in. I need to make my own custom one.
So I have this attached and printed in. I finally printed the last piece that I need to actually put Clank's animatronics together. So this little piece goes into the bottom of his head, and it lines up with this circle hole. That'll go right there, and then it could freely move on the top there once it's inside his head. All right, I've got that glued in there. Now here's the deal. These might have some trouble getting out of the way. Hopefully it's not a problem. There's a bolt on each side of the little servo arms here. So I'm gonna test him and just hold him down really good to make sure he's not too heavy and these servos actually work. If he's too heavy, I'm gonna be in a lot of trouble and I'm gonna have to start back at zero. So here we go. I'm going to plug this in. That was terrifying. All right, let's do that again. Well, the servos are holding him up. They don't appear to be straight. They appear to be way up to the side. And they're very kind of rickety. This back piece on the neck here. When I'm holding the bottom down, this is actually moving quite a bit here. He's getting turned more and more. So this is completely broken. His servos aren't strong enough at all, and the entire structure just needs to be rebuilt and stronger. His head's just too heavy.
I think we have to build a new one.
That's it for this video. Please like and subscribe for the rest of this Clank build, and go see my next video to see how I saved Clank. And as usual, happy crafting.